ever want to say, I think it's a... Because it's too awesome to comprehend. I try sticking it to him then and he's just slapped me.
I'm out off the west coast of the South Island working as a deckhand aboard a commercial albacore handline boat, and we've been hauling in loads of these tasty fish that we're carefully icing down to be sent off to market.
The waves are paid, boys!
But as the sun sets and the day's work is finished, it's time now for some recreational fishing. I've brought along some extra heavy tackle, because out here beyond the Okatika Trench, we could encounter a monster fish that could give us the fight of our lives.
Now, since I saw you guys last, it has become considerably rougher and considerably colder. However, you are not going to catch a broadbill swordfish in the comfort of your living room. However, you might be able to see one get caught, and here is one of our baits, which is one of our albacore. We caught one of the smaller sort of specimens, and that there has got a galvanized steel 14 bar O hook in it. It has got a light stick, you know, just like the kids break and play with. Now, what the light does is it attracts the attention of Mr. Swordfish. He comes along, he sees the old albacore tuna there, and he eats it. And should he become hooked, well, we are then in for the fight of our lives, because nothing is quite like a broadbill swordfish. So I won't keep you in suspense any longer, other than to say that should you come back and it be pitch dark and this reel is screaming, it's going to be all.
To fill you in on the mysterious broadbill swordfish, I've dragged out my old photo album and I've trawled through some old VHS tapes. I first encountered the mighty swordfish 10 years ago when I was working as a deckie aboard the charter boat Prime Time. We were out fishing the offshore banks beyond the Three Kings Islands for marlin, and I was living a life full of adventure.
What are you doing, Ducky? Get in there and give it to it.
My days at work were full of action and excitement. Even so, I couldn't wait for the day to end and the night to begin, because it was after dark that we would fish for broadbill swordfish. While fishing for swordfish, we'd often have encounters with big sharks, the ferocious and unpredictable Mako sharks, and the tough thresher sharks, which would fight for hours. Yet nothing came close to the fight and the power of the broadbill swordfish. These fish possess not only a heavy, bulky frame that generates power, they have remarkable stamina, with fights often going right through the night. Quite often, it was the swordfish that would come out on top in these nighttime encounters, leaving an angler exhausted and beaten. But when it all comes together, there is no bigger achievement in fishing than catching a broadbill swordfish. In the darkness, miles off the west coast of the South Island, we knew a swordfish or a shark could interrupt our slumber at any moment. So when the reel alerted us to a strike, angler, crew, skipper and cameraman all scrambled to the action station.
Here we go, more boy. Digging back down now, whatever it is. It's heavy, whatever it is. I've managed to settle down and probably really decipher that what we're dealing with here is most likely a shark, the way it's behaving. But I'd dearly love to be proved wrong. If it is a sword, it doesn't know it's really hooked, eh? Which, if it doesn't know it's hooked, means it's real big. Oh, feels nice to be hooked up, actually doing this instead of just dreaming of doing it in my slumber. Got a bit of a head shake then, it might come back at me. Get ready? Yeah. There's a bit of weight load on there. line lightly back there, but he's still ripping line.
Yeah.
There you go, we're coming back. I've got a lot of drag on and this fish is still ripping out line. So it's got some grunt, whatever it is. That we have deciphered. Other than that, can't be 100% sure what it is at all. All we can be sure of is that it's the middle of the night, a long way off the west coast of the South Island. At a time of the year, really, where no one does any fishing out here. And all we do know is that this area is home to monsters in the form of giant bluefin tuna. And if the ocean can sustain those giant bluefin, all of that feed, all that nutrients, perhaps there's other large predators here in summer. What is it now? February or something? I don't know. Put a bit of load on there, boys, hypnotizers. Yeah, sweet ass, bro. I mean, if I had to absolutely call it, I'd still say shark. But I'd dearly love to be wrong. Not that a cool, badass Marco would be a bad thing. This wouldn't be as cool as a broken swordfish. You never want to say, I think it's a... Because it's too awesome to comprehend. I tried sticking it to him then and he's just slapped me.
Well, I hope you're enjoying this classic episode, but if you'd like to see our latest content, action, tips and how-to videos, you can get it all on the Ultimate Fishing app, available now at the App Store, Google Play, or by visiting ultimatefishing.tv.
Bonus fillet right there. Taking a bit of line now. Like I'm literally like sitting down in this gear. If you can imagine, I'm putting sort of all my body weight as though I'm sitting in this harness. So the weight of the fish is coming through the rod onto this harness and I'm sitting back. If the line breaks, I'm gonna go tits up in a big hurry. It's sort of found its level where it's happy, you know? Its depth, which is a swordfish trait. Oh yeah. Yeah. He's just sitting, see, look, I can get him up a few meters, but then he's not happy. And he just goes back to that level. Woohoo! There's a couple of head shakes then. So he might change direction, so just oh yeah. Oh mate. Oh, big head shakes. Oh yeah, big head shake then, bro. We are using a mono leader, that is, there's no wire. So the longer this goes on, if it's a shark, the more likely it is for a sharp peak to just cut through that mono and we'll never get to see. Oh, big head shake. Oh, he's digging back down now. So whatever he is, he's not a little thing that I can flip over anyway, eh? He's taking line at the moment, mate. Just slowly though, eh? Big lunges. Big slow lunges. Maybe a giant squid. Down in the Hokie Trench. Middle of the night. Woo! Yeah, fast take. Yeah, man, just big hard head shakes. This is a sword or something, it's not going on any big, long, screaming runs like they can do. 400-500 meter runs, it's just short little bursts, conserving its energy. And when they're like this, and I have seen anglers, helped anglers, go almost 16 hours on these fish. I don't want that. Then again, I really want it to be a big sword, so. I guess sometimes you've got to be careful what you wish for. I have, in fact, seen grown men cry fighting swordfish. I'm not going to, but Well, unless if I do, we'll edit it out. Now, whoa, down here we go. Yeah, just dug his head in again then. Invariably people are gonna ask the question, why on earth are we doing this, bobbling around here in the middle of the night in the darkness, which makes it that much more difficult trying to catch a swordfish? And that is because during the day, the Broadbill swordfish typically lives between 400 and up to 1200 meters below the surface at times, and that's a long way down. So that presents huge challenges getting a bait down there that deep. But at the night time, they make these rapid ascents to the surface, and they feed during the hours of darkness near the surface, which is part of the mystique, if you like, of the Broadbill swordfish. They call them the Prince of Darkness because it's just so rare to see one during the day, and obviously you can't see them. And at night time, you've just got to come out here and prospect these far offshore canyons and banks, which is exactly what we're doing. We don't even know if we've got one hooked. I'm pretty much discounting a marlin because of how far south we are, but it definitely could be a shark. Woo! Oh yeah, it's woken up. Not terribly thirsty at the moment because I'm still sort of buzzing out about what's going on, but pays to take in fluids before you get thirsty. Okay, I might put a little bit of heat on him.
Okay, but yeah, I'll be trying to back up when he does those lunges, Matt, to try and...
Yeah.
He's attention a little.
There's plenty of tension, all right. Oh, far out, when he does his head check, he just about bucks me over the side of the boat.
That's right, we've got the rocks checked
up. Yeah, I know. Oh, mate, look at those head shakes. Oh, geez, Louise. There goes all that line that I worked so hard to get in. Oh, man, I'm getting a little bit anxious now because the longer this goes on, the more likely it is to be one of the things that we want. I don't even want to say it now.
Through fear of jinxing,
and I'm starting to get a little bit of belief. Oh. And it could be the opening. Gladiator, the Prince of Darkness. Oh boy, mate, he's smoking line, and it looks like we're at the stage where the heavy artillery's coming out, the gaffs. So yeah, if they can be where I can reach him. And then obviously we're quite short staffed. We're not on a sports fishing boat, so it's going to be a case of me, the angler, having to maybe grab the gaffs to secure the fish. I'm going to start swinging the mate. Can we get that fish up? Yeah, mate, I might gaff Ants, gaff Dave.
Oh, good, mate. Can't give me, Matty.
Oh, well, we're good then, bro. The old thighs are getting a bit pummeled under the load from the harness. The amount of load going on the skier. Oh. Hear that tension, that line crackling off under load. Always seems so funny when you're not the one hooked up and getting your body punished by a fish. Wardrobe change. It's like a Madonna concert.
No, it's nothing like a Madonna concert actually. I feel delirious.
Okay, back to the heavy drag and give him another. I can't let him stale, mate. He's not taking line, I'm gonna have to get some. Oh, head shakes. Man, it's not getting anywhere with him, eh? I tried sticking it to him then and he's just slapped me. I'm reevaluating my shark prediction. Because you never actually want to say it, do you? You never want to say, I think it's a... Because it's too awesome to comprehend that we've perhaps found a new summertime fishery. Once upon a time there was a resident population and they could be caught year round, but the surface longlining fleet has just decimated them. And you have to go to more exotic remote locations to find them, and I just don't want to say it. What we might have found here. Okay, got our leader. meters up. What have we got? What have we got? Yeah, it's a sword. It's a big, it's a decent big sword. Woo! Yeah. He's gonna go mental, bro. He's gonna go mental. You let him go if you have to. That's a nice swordy, boys. Yeah. Is he well hooked?
Hang on. He's got a good hold in his mouth, man.
What's that sword? Watch that big sword. It's a weapon, bro. And these things go mental. Yeah, yeah. Come down, bro. Come down, brother. Yeah! It's a sword! We found a sword! We found a sword!
It's a nice one, too.
I know. It's a fatty. Okay, so second gear, Finn. Just watch him, mate. Watch that bill.
What's up, man? Watch him.
Watch that bill. Okay, just watch him as he comes through, Dave, because he can go mental, mate. These things go separate. Okay, now that the door's open, this is when I could go, or any of us could go out of the door. Watch that bill, mate. I mean, we don't have proper game fishing flying gaffs here, so it's a bit of a problem. Watch that sword, mate, if he rears up. And I made it, they rear up, I've seen him rear up. Be careful, because we don't want to whack you, bro. Watch it. Oh, get it in, mate, and keep weight on it. Okay, one, two, three, go. Now it's that pig fins catching, man. Might have to get our cameraman to put the camera down and lend some of those big muscles, Bo, that you've been building up, but holding that camera. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Boys! Boys, even
Daisies!
Yeah. What's that, Bill? That's what we come here for, boys. That is a fatty, mate. Look at the bulk. Look at the bulk. Now, I want to be very careful because the sword is still a very dangerous weapon. You check out that sword. Okay, it's dorso ventrically flattened, which is a flash way for saying that it's flat and it is shaped just like a sword because they slash them sideways to attack their prey. And once they've got their prey, they come and feed with this relatively small mouth to the size of the fish. It's another reason why they're so hard to catch. They've got the big eye because they hunt at night and in the depths, and these stunning colours. They've got these big, hard pectoral fins and dorsal fins that are rigid, and it just locks them into their swimming style. And look at the bulk of this body. That is what I was up against. All of this power, it's full of just muscle. I mean, this is one giant muscle that kicks this big, big, powerful tail. It's got these huge caudal keels, and that is just to stabilize the amount of power going onto that tail. Without these caudal keels, that wrist of that tail would snap off with the amount of power that it generates to the tail. And I was feeling that power, but the old Shimano 80 wide got the better of him. The team got the better of him. Thank you, boys, so much.
Oh, good man.
Thanks so much, Brett, mate. That's the first one I've ever wound in. I've helped 30-odd guys catch these things.
Awesome.
Each one of them special, awesome. And that is real special. There's a whole lot of swordfish steaks to be eaten there. Summertime swords in the deep of the South Island of New Zealand. I mean, we're just checking the swordfish out. I mean, you can't help but be in awe of them. I mean, they're a completely different animal than a marlin. In fact, they're not even related to all the other billfish. And one of the unique characteristics is their skin. They've got a, now if I give this guy a slap, you'll see, this is where I've slapped them before, and where I've slapped them here, you'll see that this is gonna draw out that electric blue color, that bioluminescence. They've got an amazing ability, just like the marlin do, and a few other fish like mahi-mahi, to change their color, and they can light up, like literally light up electric blue. And as you can see, I'm not sure how it's gonna come out on camera, and you can even see all the details from the wrinkles in my fingers and everything. Just minute little microscopic beads of light in under the skin. It's really an amazing, amazing creature. Fantastic eating, and you certainly earn your fish and chips when you come out here to catch them like this, eh, boys? With the hard work done, all that remains to do is get back to Greymouth and weigh in what we believe is the first South Island swordfish caught using sport fishing tackle.
I was
going to
say 199.
Here's a fatty. 207. Sweet, went 200.
Yee-hoo!
Now what a beast.
We hope you enjoyed this classic episode. But if you want to see the latest and greatest stuff from all around the world, you can get it all for free at ultimatefishing.tv or by downloading the Ultimate Fishing app.